Hi and welcome to this week's Tech Talk. Today we're going to be looking at parallel UPS systems, and in particular we're going to focus on both the decentralised and the centralised approach. Now the terms decentralised and centralised effectively refers to the location of the static bypass within the overall UPS system. Now the primary reason to have a static bypass within the UPS system is to provide the UPS system with an automated route of power around itself should an issue arise within the UPS, and hence the UPS can no longer adequately support the critical load. In addition to this, the static bypass can also be utilised in order to clear issues on the outgoing side of the UPS, such as overloads or short circuits. And therefore, should an issue arise, the UPS system will simply transfer the load onto the static bypass, allow the issue to be resolved, and then once it's resolved, can transfer the load back onto the output and the inverter completely seamlessly. Now on the board here, we have two systems. We've got the decentralized system and we've got the centralized system. Now the main difference between the two systems is the location of the static bypass. In the decentralized system, we have three UPSs, 1, 2, and 3. Now obviously you can use either more or less UPS systems, and that applies to both the decentralized and the centralized. Whereas in the centralized system, we have three UPS systems, and inside each of the UPS, there is a dedicated static bypass per UPS, and therefore the bypasses are split across the UPS modules and hence they are decentralized. However, if we look at the centralized system, we again have the same three UPS systems, albeit this time we don't have any static bypasses within the UPS modules, and therefore because it is a centralized system, all of the static bypass components are located in a centralized bypass cabinet, and hence the term centralized. Now both the decentralized and centralized systems are perfectly viable UPS systems for every kind of power situation. Whereas some people do prefer the decentralized over the centralized, and in some cases, consultants and customers have a definitive preference as to which one they employ. Now, if you need to make that decision as to which version of installation you wish to go with, then we can discuss just some of the key points which may help you make that final decision. Firstly, if we look at costs. In terms of costs, we can split this down firstly into the actual UPSs themselves. In the decentralized system, you've got three UPS systems, 1, 2, and 3, each with their own static bypasses. Whereas in the centralized system, you've again got the three UPS modules. However, because you've got the additional fourth cabinet, which contains the static bypass and all of the controlling architecture within that system, the centralized bypass solution is typically slightly more expensive than the decentralized approach, and therefore just something to consider in terms of the overall equipment. In addition to this, you must consider the switchgear requirements. In the decentralized system, where we have simple single supply input to each of the UPS systems, i.e. the breaker that's supplying the UPS will feed both the rectifier and the bypass line. In this scenario, the switchgear would only require to be fitted with three input supply breakers and three outgoing load switches. However, with the centralized system, you still have the same number of input breakers and output switches for the UPS modules. However, now you have a separate bypass cabinet which would also require an additional supply circuit breaker and an additional output load switch, and therefore that can increase the cost of the electrical switchgear around the system. And in addition to that, the bypass module would have to be rated to the maximum power connected to the output of the system, and hence the supply breakers to the bypass module could be significantly larger. However, there's something you must consider between these two systems, in that the centralized system here is effectively dual input, because you have the rectifier modules being fed from one source and you have the bypass module here being fed from another source or another breaker, and therefore it's effectively dual input. Now, if you wanted to apply that to the decentralized solution up on the top diagram, you would have to increase the number of breakers feeding each UPS to two, one for the rectifier and one for the bypass line, and therefore the switchgear would have to contain six input circuit breakers, that's two per UPS system, and therefore you must consider the installation method in terms of the additional costs of the actual switchgear, which is typically overlooked. In addition to the cost, you've got to consider the initial investment and the future planning, Because at the end of the day, if you have a decentralized system, you can simply add modules in the future and therefore increase the capacity of the overall system. Whereas with a centralized system, you must consider the rating of the bypass module. Because if the bypass module at day one is not rated to deal with the load that will be applied at day two, then potentially you could end up having to replace that module with a larger module to suit the expansion in load. Or in addition to that, if you do plan from day one with a much larger module than you will ever need, then it could be a very expensive purchase and you could end up with a static bypass module which is far oversized for the final installation. So they're just some of the main costs that you need to consider. The next thing you can consider is the resilience of the system. Now we can break this down into two areas. Firstly, into terms of operation. Well, in generally, in terms of operation, both systems are, in some case, most cases, just as reliable and resilient as each other. However, some people do consider having the single bypass module to be a potential single point of failure, which quite rightly it is. Now, some people will say, well, okay, in order to get over that, I can just add in a second bypass module and hence have two bypass modules to remove that single point of failure. However, by doing so, you are simply mimicking the decentralized approach, so it would be a very, very cost prohibitive method of installation. In addition to the operation resilience, we've got to consider the maintenance resilience. The decentralized system, if we need to maintain the UPS, we simply power down the UPS, maintain the UPS, and power the UPS system back on. However, whilst that UPS system is being maintained, the remaining operational module can still support the critical load and provide static bypass availability at all times. Whereas with a centralized system, again, you can maintain the UPS modules with no problems whatsoever without dropping resilience. However, when you need to maintain the static bypass module, you're effectively removing the bypass availability to all of the UPS system, and hence, during maintenance, the resilience level is reduced. Now, one of the biggest points on why people install a centralized system is what's referred to as power balancing whilst on static bypass. Now, what I mean by this is effectively, in a decentralized system, if we go to bypass, we effectively bypass each of the three UPS systems. Now, depending on the length of the cables that are fitted between the incomer and the load through the UPS system will dictate the current flowing through each of the UPS systems. Now, if that's not carefully installed from day one, potentially during bypass operation, you could overload some conductors and therefore cause inadvertent nuisance tripping of the supply circuit breakers. So that's something you need to consider. In addition to that, during extreme circumstances, in order to aid the balancing of that current, you may have to fit line reactors in order to facilitate the balancing. However, line reactors would add a significant cost increase to the overall system. Whereas with a centralized system, because you've only got that single bypass line, you've no longer got any power balancing issues, and hence, for many large installations, the centralized with a single bypass line is the preferred choice. Finally, we've got to consider floor space. Now, floor space is going to be very heavily dictated by the method of installation, because obviously you've got to consider the switchgear floor space, and then you've got to consider the module floor space. Okay, so effectively, obviously, if floor space is at a premium, you have to very carefully design the overall system for most suitable for your applications. But it's something it's imperative that you do consider. Well, I hope you found this tech talk useful, and I hope you learned a little more around the decentralized and the centralized systems. However, if you do have a question for us here at Riello, then please drop us an email to techtalk@riello-ups.co.uk. Thank you.